See what do I gotta do today? Well, right now I kinda don't feel like doing anything, and my head's a fucking mess. It's a curse. My head's always filled with thoughts and ideas, but my physical body cannot handle such ideas. Like, as in physically, I mean, when I get an idea, I get another one right away, and I only have one me, and my one me only has two hands, and these two hands only have five fingers, as well as 2 feet, a head, a nose, two eyes, one mouth, and one brain, who apparently has like 3 million thoughts per second. It's horrible. Very sad, very guilty feeling. I get so many ideas, and I know that in my entire lifetime, I'll never be able to do all of the ideas I have in my mind. And, 99% of them are probably really shitty anyway. Oh, the problems of a creative person who is too creative. Yep, me, too creative. Yep. Yes, that's totally me. I'm such a creative and a unique, gifted child. Didn't I already lower the levels? Okay, good. I can play. So let's see here. Hello, Monica, cheer on for me, will you? So that's on my to-do. Nope, it's raining. Perfect. Just perfect. Na na na. So now I'm going to play Tetris to clear my head a little bit. God, I left the scene for a little while, and then it turns out, like, it's apparently the norm now to score a million and max out. Like, people are actually honestly considering just getting rid of the term max out. That's how good people have gotten. And look at me, my highest score is still only 26. 268K. Why? How are people this good and talented? It's probably because they have focus, unlike me, who's just a bumbling bitch boy with whose thoughts are always a spiraling mess and can't get them together. I don't know if I'd feel better if I found out and if it was diagnosed to be some sort of mental illness. I've read up a lot of psychology and a lot about mental illnesses, but I've never, in my studies, come across an illness or anything, or any kind of thing that describes the thing that I'm feeling, where my head's always filled with thoughts and I can't get rid of them. This is a really good run so far. I haven't fucked up yet. I doubt that'll last long though, because I'm pretty sure I just jinxed myself. Maybe I should try hyper tapping, because apparently you just can't survive the current meta now, unless you're a hyper tapper. And actually, I watch Classic Tetris monthly, May. And it seems like the two hyper tappers that are there, the only reason they're surviving is because they're already pretty good. Competition's really hot. And I really have no chance of competing anymore, honestly. Pretty demoralizing. Regardless, I'll keep playing and having fun anyway. Because that is the true spirit of games. So why is playing without the next pieces really hard? For a noob, they might not understand because they probably don't look at the next pieces. But to someone who's a pro, and you, if you play like me, if you look at me, if I have an eye tracker, you'd know that I look down at the screen all the time. And then after I place down a piece, I immediately look at the next piece. I never look at the top, so I don't really see what piece is dropping down, because I just know because I looked at the next piece. So when you take away the next piece bar thingy, that means you actually have to consciously look up now, which is something a lot of us aren't really used to. A lot of us are pro players. And I know I'm calling myself a pro player here, but you get the gist. I think that's why having no next piece showing is really confusing and hard. Just from my experience, I mean, I don't know how other players or actual Tetris pros see their screen, but this is how I see my screen. Always looking at the board, never at the top, because there's no point in looking at the top. Okay, I'm getting some really bad pieces now. Well, it all started with a bad piece placement, honestly. Ha! Eat shit, commentators! I can actually say piece placements properly. Yeet. It all started with a bad piece placement. My pieces have all just been good. But then I made a mistake. I made a bad piece drop. When I should have placed it somewhere else. Oh god. Turning into quite a doozy. Is this the end for moi? Daga katawaru! That means I refuse in Japanese. It's also a JoJo reference. Mostly a JoJo reference. Just a JoJo reference. Yes, thank god, lucky RNG. I am being blessed with so many eyepieces to help me clean up. Arigato kami-sama! Kami-sama arigato! Man, I wanna play that song now, but I'm too busy, and I can't pause. Pausing is illegal. Oh shit, I wasn't paying attention. I have already transitioned. Look at that, my dash is terrible too! Shit! Oh god! That's the problem with me hyper tapping too! Oh, I give up. That's the problem when I hyper tap. I suck at counting my taps. So sometimes I over tap or under tap. It's kind of like the same problem with dash when you're early shifting. But different. Because instead of a timing problem, it's still a mental problem, timing problem. I was in a very not good position when I transitioned. That's the headline there. Lovely spire, I say. That's sarcasm, by the way. There's never such a thing as a lovely spire in Classic Tetris. Modern Tetris too, really. Because when you have a spire, especially if it's in the center, that means someone can fucking kill you. With a good line clear. Like, just one line of garbage would literally kill you if it gets sent over. God dang it. Bad piece placements. Bad decisions. That MP4. I can't Tetris because I keep making bad decisions. I needed to place that there because I'm really just focused on cleaning right now. You know, Tetris is a good allegory for doing chores. If you don't do your chores, you lose. So do your chores, kids. Remember to do your chores and clean the house. Well, actually, yeah, cleaning your house is still important. If you don't, dust will get everywhere and you'll get sick. There's a reason we have canal systems in modern society. Because otherwise, if we don't have them, we're gonna fucking die by cholera or some shit like that. So clean your house. I mean, right now we are suffering a pandemic as well, aren't we? Coronavirus. So clean your house and maintain social distancing. Yeah. I'm dying now because I'm too busy giving a lecture. Fuck! Can I get a dirty Tetris, please, God?
Ah! No!
I should have hyper tapped. I could have made it if I maintained my proper dash shift, but nah. My dash sucks. Knife you mote yashita. Fuck. Fuck. Again. Fuck. Fuck this. I give up. I lose. You take the win, whoever I'm fighting against. Which is no one. Sadly. Shit, my skill stopping. It is very, not skillful. Dang it. Nasira yan, wala tayong papalitan yan. The door, shed the lights, a barricade against the sky. Don't make a sound or speak too loud. The goal can never see the light. It's static scenery of plastic imagery, coast to simulate contact. A full menagerie of more than fantasy, dust to dust, ashes to black. What can I say? I'm locked in this state. Okay. Nope. Reality is lost on me. I speak too late, the girl I wish to be. Midnight's turn to dawn and mornings are gone. That's a risk. Ah! What a sight to behold for sure. Sporadic ventures of the manic nature. Do it fast or watch it burn. What can I say? I'm locked in this state. You guys might have noticed it. But yeah, I have a game genie code that skips the cutscene. It's a very, let's say, heated topic, whether you should do that or not. Honestly, you really shouldn't care. If you don't like skipping the cutscene, then don't skip the cutscene. Personally, I want more time playing and less time watching cutscenes. I mean, come on, who doesn't hate unskippable cutscenes nowadays in our modern day gaming society? We should have the freedom to skip cutscenes. Blah blah blah, I don't care if it's history. If you've seen a cutscene, you have the right to skip it. That's my hot take. Deal with it. Of isolation, from isolation created salvation. This song sends a very clear and good message. If you isolate, you there will be salvation for humankind. Oh. This is the good piece placement. But these are not the good pieces. Clean! Tetris! Yeah! That ended up working out, even though it was a misdrop. It wasn't a misdrop, it was intentional. It was all planned. You cannot disprove it. But you also can't prove it either, I guess, so, yeah. Got me thinking though. I'm gonna need to stop playing if I wanna talk about it though. So because it's really important and I'm having a really good run right now. I don't wanna fuck it up by me talking. Almost there, the transition. Better be prepared. Shit. No! Oh! Hyper tapping mode activated! Oh shit! Ah, mistaking mode activated. Yeah, I beat my record. Fuck you. Fuck yeah. Fuck me.
I'm almost there, baby! I'm almost at 3K! Anyway, I want to talk about this. Since everyone's getting million scores now, and since Classic Tetris Monthly still doesn't use same piece or random number, random generation of pieces, how much of Classic Tetris Monthly is actually just decided by luck as opposed to skill now? Right? Because if everyone can score a million now, and if everyone can play perfectly and always get Tetrises, spare me for this thought experiment, imagination thingy I have in mind, but yeah. When you think about it, right? If everyone can play perfectly and every time they get a line, it's always a Tetris, that means in Classic Tetris Monthly, with them not having the same pieces, what if someone gets more eye pieces than the other guy, and both of them, all of their eye pieces, they were able to use to score a Tetris? That means the one with the best RNG, the winner will only be decided by RNGesus. So yeah, competitive Tetris needs to be standardized, and it needs to be standardized with both players having the same pieces, because we don't want luck being a factor anymore. It's a serious problem that needs to be discussed and taken care of. Do you like me? Aw, man, if I placed my pieces a little better, I could have gotten a Tetris. Ah, shit. I still focus on upstacking. I didn't notice that I could have used that to score Tetris instead. Oops. I said spin twice. The fuck? My taps didn't register. Lucky, lucky, lucky. I'm safe. I'm alive. Has a lot of eye pieces and a whole lot of not Tetrising with those eye pieces. Very regretful. My transition game is something I need to practice on. Because I'm so used to playing at the same speed all the time. I need to remember that the game speeds up. And I need to practice being able to shift gears like that. It really is just like in a car where you need to shift your gear. Shit, that didn't clear anything. I thought it did. I thought it would. Oh god. Whole lot of cerebral burning right now, and a whole lot of not very good pieces. You must remember that the Tetris gods always hate you. And will never be in your favor. God, I need another oh, thanks. I'm 75% on the way. That's when you need the moment when you need to mentally prepare for a transition, I believe, should be when you're only 10 lines left. I don't know, I think I watch a lot of competitive Classic Tetris, and that seems to be the time when people mentally prepare themselves to shift speed. I'm not Daijobu. I am not prepared for a transition right now. Very much not prepared for a transition. Shit. Not good. I need to clean up. I'm gonna switch to hyper tapping mode now. I hate this color scheme. Level 18! Oh god, level 19! Oh! Fuck! Maybe I should practice my level 19 play. That'll be fun, right? Oh my god! It's too fast! I can't dash! I know my mind is fast enough, but my body is not. Doesn't that perfectly describe how I play fighting games? that literally is me whenever I play fighting games. I can mentally adapt, but my physical body cannot handle all the inputs. I'm like, do the Hadouken, and then I try to do the Hadouken, and then the game said no, and then I'm like, fuck, guess I'll die now. Alright. Unless I want to face the unless I want to stand toe-to-toe with the masters of Tetris, like Joseph and Jonas, I must be able to handle level 19! Why is Vsauce music playing? God, I can't handle it. It's too fast. I'll do level 18 instead. Yeah, you gotta shift gradually, you know. This one I can dash. This one's pretty slow. Okay, unless shit like that happens, in which case, what the fuck, man? Fuck this. How do dash players deal with level 19 speed? Also, I'm kind of struggling with level 18. Anyway, yeah, I should practice level 18 before I practice level 19. I've graduated from level 15. I'm now ready to take on level 18. Can't be too hasty now. Gotta do level 18 before you do level 19 remix. The ABCs. You gotta learn the alphabet before you learn how to construct the sentence. That's what I always say, that's the quote I live by. But honestly, I have already learned the ABCs, and now it's time for me to learn words and vocabulary before I can construct a sentence. That's how you learn a language, folks, I think. Fuck. I can't seem to make my mind up. Do I want the hyper tap, or do I want the delayed auto shift? That's really what's killing me here. And I've decided I'm going to dash. Cursed RNG. Fuck. Okay. When I get to halfway up the screen, it really is deadly. People weren't joking. When you're halfway through the screen, it's deadly. That's the danger zone. Yes, I meant to pronounce danger like that. I'm in the danger zone. Hanasanai de Kurachi wa utanto yo. Daijoubu ja arimasen. Ah, Chine. If you have shit stamina, you're kind of forced to play hybrid, where you're dashing for the most part, but when things get intense, that's when you switch to hyper tapping. Because otherwise, you'll tire yourself out. You need to switch between just normal hyper tapping, just fast enough that you can put your pieces into place. You need to learn when to use the correct speed. Hey, I scored a Tetris, finally. Not good. Not good. Danger zone. Tetris. Oh god. Oh god. Fuck. Fuck. Let me score one more Tetris. Yes. Now I can die happy. But I would prefer not dying. Oh god. The timing really is tricked. I can't T-spin. Scored 100k on level 18. Nice. Nice. Very good, Mr. Joestar. I'm through playing level 18. 15. Forever. From now on, I'll only play level 18. I'll always start at level 18 from now on. Otherwise, I might as well say goodbye to my Tetris career. Can't believe I made it. Proper death when I needed it the most, and I got it. Deska. Shit! No! Oh god! No! Bullshit, fuck this. Ugh. I've gotten addicted. I'll stop once I hit the 1 hour mark. And if I don't stop in the 1 hour mark, I set my Bandicam to stop recording after 1 hour and 30 minutes of recording has passed. So, I will stop eventually. Whether or not I keep on playing even once the recording has stopped, that's yet to be known. That's a mystery. I don't need to tap that fast when I'm this low. Something a lot of hyper tappers need to realize is that you don't always have to be tapping super fast. Newbie hyper tappers, I mean. It's good to learn and know how to tap fast. But you gotta know that there are just times where you don't need to tap that fast, you know? And there are also just times where you gotta fuck. Things just get real fucky. Uh-huh. Danger zone indeed. Much danger zone. Now this is what I call a horrible start. Fuck. I forced myself into a T-spin setup. Ah! Fuck! Ugh! If I scream hard, I didn't scream hard enough. That's why it didn't work. T-spinning isn't about timing, it's about how hard you scream when you try it. That's the true secret. The one true secret that nobody else is brave enough to tell because they don't wanna, you know. They're lying to you so that they can forever be the T-spin kings. But I am out here to speak the truth. To expose the lies that the pros have been deceiving you with. Yes, for this is the truth. Hear my words, for what I speak is the truth. When you T-spin, it is all about how hard you scream. There is no deception or falsity in those words, folks. What I said was not but 100% the truth. I say as demonic metal music plays on the background. And I thought Dan Maku Unlimited had a pretty good metal soundtrack. Then Doom just comes along and says, "Dahab, synth go brrrr!" Alright, how do I fix this mess? And I will not accept "you don't" as an answer. For there's always a way. Even if it is just plain luck that decides. Whew, I'm tired. I want to practice my T-spin setups. Want to practice T-spinning. Alright, we got it set up now. Just gotta wait for that T now. Oh, here it is. Shit! I spun wrong. Dang. Alright, we got this, we got this. We can do this, boys. Watch. I play modern Tetris. I'll get it eventually, trust me. Because I'm a modern Tetris gamer. Yeah! See, I told you! Fuck! Well, I can't go for another T-spin. Topping out time. I need to practice and get used to the timing of my spins, because it will be very important and vital. Now, if I can just get the correct fucking... Okay, fuck you. Oh wait, no, oh man, there was a T-spin setup right there, No. Fuck. I can't even set my T-spin setups. Can I just play modern Tetris now? I just want a T-spin. Fuck. Oh well. Alright, I got it. Now let's see if we can do it again. Not like that. That's not a T-spin setup. Okay, I can't do any more T-spins. Well, I guess that's a T-spin setup. A very easy one. Man, nah. If I placed that box there, that would have been another T-spin setup for me to attempt. Alright, I'm getting it. I'm getting used to it. I'm getting the rhythm. Aw, dang it. Ah. Alright, here's another T-spin setup. It's all chill. Aw, man. Alright, I've got it. But I'm gonna keep on trying anyway. Just keep on practicing until it's... The timing is just second nature. I need to hone my accuracy. Ah, that was another T-spin setup there. Fuck! Ah! I need to rotate 180 clockwise, counterclockwise, and then rotate once clockwise. All in the span of like 8 frames. That would have been impossible. Starting to think I just got lucky with those past few attempts. But I plan to change that. Sakomo hime mi ni hanamaru tsuke yo. Uki wa izutsu no hita kono konda. Alright, 55 minutes in, time for one last level 18 game. Or maybe I should try playing level 15 and see if I can get 300k. Hmm. Mamo, level 15. Let's go. 300k, we can do it, boys. Cheer me on. Everyone who's watching this, which is probably like nobody. Then I guess you'll have to do, Monica. You'll cheer me on. Kawaranai de te sutto koko ni ide. Koko ni ide. Oh! Ah! One more attempt. We can do this. That was just a warm-up. Now it's the real deal. I was starting to get too used to level 18 speed. Yeah. That's not me making excuses, like people. That's me making excuses. Everything changed, faded. Everybody faded. Kawaranai de te sutto koko ni ide. Mate! Wait! Wow, those were two Tetrises I didn't get because apparently I'm stupid. Thank you. Ah, it was a valiant attempt. Ah. I'm gonna stay here a little longer. I wanna enjoy the music. And then I'm gonna stop the recording. I saw a video of Jonas teaching a newbie, a drummer or something, I guess, YouTuber. And he said, if you want to get to Classic Tetris competitively, you should start at level 5. And I'm like, what? Jonas? Excuse me? No, don't start. Don't start at level 5. Start at level 0, because ain't a normal person. Duh. What do you mean start at level 5? Are you a fool? You should start at level 0. That just makes a lot of sense. Why would you start at anything but level 0? You have absolutely no experience with Tetris, or even if you have experience in modern Tetris, and maybe even if you already have experience, then yeah, you should start at level 5 and then build up from there. Or maybe you could progressively slope up from level 0 until and slowly go up, like what I'm doing. Well, I did skip level 16 and went and 17 and went straight to 18, didn't I? So I don't know. Depends on you. Point is, everyone progresses at their own pace. So, yeah. Start at level 0. Oh, well, the music's over. Let me score one more Tetris. Whee! Okay, now I can go die. Yee-hee! Should try doing a challenge, see how many lines I can clear before the music stopped. Oh well.